Hot Wheelers, what's happening? Joe Motor back with you here. It is pouring rain, thundering and lightning outside, and it's the month of October, which means Halloween is coming up. So I thought I would do a video of a couple of die-cast pieces here and tip our hat to Halloween. Now, it's one of my favorite holidays. I know, Matt Slycord, it's one of your favorite holidays, and I'm sure a lot of you guys enjoy Halloween. You know, it's not technically a holiday, I guess, but it is a lot of fun and for a lot of different reasons. So I always like to do a video with a little Halloween theme. Now, last year, you remember Hot Wheels released a nostalgia or pop culture set for monsters, and so it was Wolfman and Frankenstein and Dracula and all that kind of stuff. And that was a pretty cool set. And so this year I've got a couple of green lights. And so we're going to take a look at those. But first I wanted to show you this Baja Breaker here. This piece is from the pop culture or nostalgia series, which just got released. And it's from the Muppets. So it's not technically Halloween, but it does have orange and black on it. So we're going to start with that anyway. But this is a really cool piece. They've got several cars in the latest pop culture release that have Muppet themed vehicles, but this was by far my favorite one. The Baja Breaker is one of my favorite castings, and it's got the Zaymac finish on it, which is super cool, and it's got Beaker and Dr. Bunsen on the side, which is even cooler. They're two of my favorite hilarious characters on the old Muppet Show, and I think everybody should watch the old Muppet shows and Muppet movies, because those are just classic stuff. And they're not the same tempo on either side either. So here they're both looking at you, and then over here they've got a different kind of expression. So it's different on both sides. And then also you'll notice all these tiny little drawings, little diagrams, scientific diagrams, and there's Beaker's name, and there's Dr. Bunsen. You can see it kind of written on the sides. It's almost like they hand wrote it on the side of the van here. See all those little tampos. They're much easier to see in person, so I'm just trying to kind of give you a once-over. On the back, you've got the Muppet Show tampo. You've got those diagrams. Super cool. Orange windows in the back. And then you've got the orange top. And then the all-blacked-out front, which is super mean-looking. Nice painted headlights. And then the base is all black. It's got a nice, flat, black metal base, which is super cool. That 2022 would make you think it's the year 2022. Not quite. Beautiful, beautiful stuff. And those Rough Rider, Real Rider tires here with the orange line. Very nice. Super, super nice model with the orange interior. And it reminds me of the Baja Breaker they released in the Nose Art series a few years back. So they look pretty good together, don't you think? But this one I'm not calling the Baja Breaker. I'm calling this one, have you guessed yet? The Baja Beaker. Or Beaker's Baja Breaker. You could call it either one of those. But this one is fantastic. It's going in the display case. I bought it loose so I didn't have to crack it. So wanted to start with that one. But let's take a look at these for the Halloween releases. These are two green lights that just came out in the new Hollywood release. And there's quite a few cool ones. The Hangover is one that was pretty cool, but I don't really collect police cars, so I didn't get that one. But this one I had to get, and this one is just totally cool. This is the Gremlins, and if you've never seen this movie, I recommend seeing it. I think there were two or three Gremlins movies. And so if you don't know anything about the Gremlins, this is Gizmo, and he's the cute little furry gremlin. And but if you get them wet, or if they stay up past midnight, if I remember correctly, they turn into the evil, mean gremlins. And as you can see, they cause a lot of trouble. They go out drinking and gambling, and they just cause a lot of trouble, and very unpleasant gremlins, as you can see there. So very cool that they put the artwork on the back like this. I think they do a better job with the artwork sometimes than Hot Wheels Retro Entertainment. Retro Entertainment seems to just kind of put the logo and that's it. But at least there's some movie stills here from this. And then you also have the Volkswagen seal, the officially licensed seal right there, which is kind of a nice addition. And then here's the Beetle. And I really, really like this model because it's got kind of a It's sort of a salmon color, like a, it's not totally red and it's not really orange. It's not really pink. It's kind of a peachy red salmon color. And it looks pretty much exactly like it did in the movie, the guy who carries Gizmo around in his little beetle. And so I'm not going to crack it because the whole point of this thing is kind of to see it associated with the movie logo and everything. So I'm going to keep these in the package. But I saw Dicastic 1 crack his open, and the details are great on this thing, but he seemed to think it had a plastic base, and it looks like it is a plastic base, which is kind of disappointing. So if you're paying $5 for these cars, you really do expect to have a metal base. So Greenlight, I don't know if you spent too much on the license or what, but it would be nice to have a metal base on the cars we're spending those bucks for. But, you know, the wheels look fantastic. They have the VW on the hubcap. Can you see that? And the wheels they look great. So this is a awesome little bug to have. And love this packaging. Handle with care. Don't get them wet. So the other one that just came out is Friday the 13th. And this one is, you know, a horror franchise. Jason Voorhees, in case you don't know about Friday the 13th, Jason Voorhees, as a kid, was bullied and drowned in Crystal Lake at a summer camp, and he comes back to life and takes out revenge on all the summer campers year after year after year. I think there's like, what, 8 or 9 Friday the 13th movies, and then there's a Jason in Space, and then there's Freddy versus Jason, so there's all kinds of franchising that's happening with this piece here. So just a classic horror movie from the 80s, and it's kind of cool that they put a police car, because obviously Jason's doing a lot of machete slashing, so there's a lot of police that have to show up, and or usually these old Dodge Monaco type police cars. So like I said, I don't normally collect police cars, but for this particular one, and because of the Halloween video, I decided to go ahead and do it. Why not, right? So, very cool idea and very cool detailing on these cars. Of course, Greenlight, you expect that sort of thing. So, really like it, and I'm really glad that Greenlight has decided to do some things you might not expect. Like, I never expected to see Gremlins or Friday the 13th. And, you know, Hot Wheels kind of rips Greenlight off because, you know, Greenlight had the Fast and Furious license, and then Hot Wheels did it. And then Greenlight had the Anchorman van. Well, guess what? Now Hot Wheels is doing it. And what else have they got that they've been doing? I think Christine is going to be done by Hot Wheels. And, of course, Christine was done by Auto World. And that's also a Halloween-related one, but I did a video of Christine a few videos back. We looked up at close and personal at Christine, so check that video out, the haunted car. But it's really cool to see Greenlight doing some stuff you wouldn't expect. And the one thing I think is really strange about this piece is they include Mrs. Voorhees, and I don't understand why. Like, I know that, you know, Greenlight does these 1/64th diorama people, but why not do Jason? You know, it seems pretty obvious that you would want to do the main character. Well, my guess is that Jason was too expensive to license, so to actually do the likeness of Jason with the hockey mask and the machete, it was too much money, and Greenlight didn't want to pay it. So the next best thing was to do Jason's mom, who is the really only other villain in the Jason movies. And so, for some reason, instead of doing Jason, they decided to do Mrs. Voorhees. Now, I could be wrong. They may release another car with the Friday the 13th logo and stuff, and maybe Jason will come out in that. Because it's actually a good idea, because there's a lot of pop culture and horror fans out there that might enjoy putting together a Friday the 13th diorama. I mean, that'd be kind of cool for horror fans who also like diecast and minifigures and things like that. So it's just an idea, but my hunch is that Jason was too expensive to license. So there's your Mrs. Voorhees, even though she rarely makes an appearance in the movies. It seems a little strange, but at least they're trying, right? So, anyway, I hope you guys enjoy your Halloween this year. I think it's on a Friday night, so you should definitely stay up late, watch scary movies, eat lots of candy that's bad for you, and just have a lot of fun. So, that'll do it for this video. Again, happy Halloween, and we'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching. P.S. I have to show this car one more time just because it's a Halloween video. This piece right here is a Johnny Lightning funny car. I think it's a Dodge Charger funny car that was given to me by Shad Juice in an REOK. So if you didn't see my REOK from Shad Juice, then I had to include this video here in this little Halloween theme piece. The Scream Team. Check it out. It's got the little goblins in the back who are spooking up on you there. And then they're also on the hood. And then their creepy eyes are on the top canopy here. Super spooky cool. So Shad Juice, thanks again. He sent me that in an REOK recently. And I just had to pull it out one more time since we're doing a Halloween themed video today. So thanks again for watching, and we'll see you next time. Happy Halloween.